Hi guys, welcome to Tutor Funny channel. Today I'm going to teach how to edit the records. So let's close the program. So here, this is the J table where the records will be displayed. So select the J table and right click. Here events. Here you have to select the event as mouse clicked event. Why I am selecting the mouse click event mean? What is the row you are selected and the details will be displayed on these text boxes, and what is the things you have to change, you change and click edit button, record is edited successfully. So that select the J table, right click, event, key, sorry, mouse clicked. Right here you have to write first default, again you have to write default table model, select as d1 object I create as d1. Here we have to cast this one like this dot j table one dot, what is the name of the J table? J table one, why is the properties not displayed? Dot here, what's the problem is here, you no need here now. Okay, get model. Okay, I put extra dot, that's why the property is not displayed. Right now here I have created the integer variable, select index equal j table one dot get selected row. Right, that's the top we have to do. After that we have to, when the user select on the record should be displayed on these text boxes for edit. So you have to specify the names. So this one for txt reg, so here you have to type txt reg dot we have to pass this object d1 dot get values, and here the selected index this index 0 is 0 position, the id will be in 0 position here. So here, okay, right, what is the error? Right here we have to give the things as toString method, so the error should go away. We have to give this. Right now the things we have to copy this one and paste here. Right, this one for which one? Make. So txt make, just copy this one and paste here. This one position 1, this one position 1, this one 0, 1, 2, 3, right. So this 1, 2 mean txt model, 3 mean this one, 4, what is this, change variable t com avl. So we have to, this one, here we have to put the index as 3, this one for not the text because this is a combo box, so you have to type it selected item. Right, that's the stuff you have to type. Right now let's execute the program and check whether it's working fine or not. John 1, 2, 3, select this one here. It successfully here, it record will be display here for init. Here record will be successfully display for init. Okay, here successfully display the record for init. Now what I'm going to do is here, if I change something else and click edit button, record is ready, record should be edited. So let me see how to do the task. Now go to the edit button, double click on the edit button here. I'm going to write the codes. So here first I'm going to write the this one, same thing here, copy this one, Ctrl C to copy, Ctrl V to paste here. Here I have to write the second stuff, this one, Ctrl C to copy, Ctrl V to paste this one. Here you have to write the drivers, this one, class for drivers minus this one, Ctrl C to copy this one, Ctrl V to paste. Right, now here we have to import the try and catch. This one we have to Ctrl X to cut and Ctrl V to paste here. Let's add catch this one. After that here what I'm going to do is here, I'm going to create the variables, and here string id equal this variable, this object dot get value, this one. Here we have to select a index, this one. Here position of 0 dot toString, right, this is a variable. This when the user click on the row which you want to edit, the particular id will be 0 position, means the id will be passing to the this variable, id variable. So that's the stuff we have done. So here we have to copy all the variables. Here we have to, what I'm going to do is enter, make this one model. So here we have to mod this one, we have to status, right, this one position of, not this a position, this one, so we have to passing the appropriate text box. So we have to call this text boxes, this one make txt makes dot get text, Ctrl C to copy, Ctrl V to paste, this one model, final one. This one. Here we have to put, this is a combo box, so we have to select get selected item dot toString. That call the toString method. Right. That's the stuff you have to do. Right. These are the variables we have to assign to the particular variables. Okay, these are the, what are the data, when the user click edit button, so all the data will be passing here, it's passing to the relevant variables, look like this. Now here I'm going to write the edit query. So we have to write the prepare statement, we have to write all the prepare statement above here, PST, this object, you just copy this one, right, here is PST equal con connection object dot prepare statement, this one. Here we have to write the update query, so here write as update. Here we have to write the table name, which the name you have to upload, this table name, car registration is a table name, write this. Here we have to set make to the database columns. This is the database car sorry LOS rent. Inside the database there will be the table car registration. This is the columns, so we just copy this one. If you leave any mistake of the spelling mistake, you just copy and paste it here. Equal question. Right, that's the stuff we have to do. And the finally we have to call the ID where we have to call this ID. The co-ID is this one, car number, this one. Yeah, copy this one. Equal. Right, that's the stuff we have to do. Right, okay. Now here what I'm going to do is here first I'm going to write the query as PST dot set string one make. Second one, we copy this one, paste this one for mod, call mod this variable. Third one for status, call this one. Right, this is the thing we have to update. And that the finally we have to call the ID, this one 2, this one 3, 1 2 3. Final one will be the ID. Proceed to copy it, will be to paste here. ID, we have to get the ID, this one, this ID we have to paste it here, this one for 4. Right, that's the thing we have to do. Finally we have to call the PST dot execute update method, execute update method for update stuff. Okay, if it is above all are correct, you have to call the dialog. This here we have to call that as edit. Right, that's enough we have to do. That's the only thing we have to do. Right, after updated we have to call the table update method for refresh the table. So we have to call that function, we have to call them. After get this message, the table should be refreshed. Right, now let's check whether it's working fine or not. I'm going to update this record, click on this one here, the record displayed successfully. Now here I'm going to change this new edition ED. Right, now click edit button here, record updated. Click OK, look at the J table, click OK. Here table will be successfully changed itself. Okay, that's why I call the method table update, it is refreshed. I hope you guys you understood so far. In my next tutorial, I'm going to teach how to delete the records from the database. Thank you for watching.